Hey friends and everyone, welcome back to Netcode-Hub channel. You know my name, right? I am Frederick and I'm happy to meet you here today. In this video, we're going to talk about a new feature that has been added to .NET 8 Blazor. And that is, are you aware of it? You can now create a simple website in less than 10 minutes, 5 minutes. Well, it depends on the speed. You can create a simple website and perform all the CRUD operations, create, read, update, and delete automatically with using the scaffolding new feature added to .NET 8 Blazor. Are you aware of it? Do you know how to work with that? I'm going to show you today if you don't. Well, before we just get right into this, make sure you subscribe to this channel and also click on that bell to receive an update as soon as I do upload new content. Yes, without much further ado, let's jump right into this. Make sure you have your Visual Studio 2022 or higher installed. Create a new project. Now, this new scaffolded options happens in only the server. So, this can work in the interactive server, interactive WebAssembly on the server, and interactive auto on the server. The reason is, you're going to create a DB context class. It's going to install packages such as EF Core Tools, SQL Server or SQLite, or any database provider that you want to use. And you know, this must happen on the server. Alright, so let's jump right into this and see how we can do this. So I'm going to create a new project, and this is going to be Blazor, as you know. So Blazor web app, and we're going to use interactive server for now. Then I'm going to give you a project name, demo CRUD with scaffold, because that is the feature that we're going to introduce in here. Now click on next to get this project created. We need to choose an interactive server. It's going to be an auto, this fine, or we can go in for the server as well. Okay, any of them is still going to work because we're going to tackle the aspect of the server. Now we want to include sample pages, interactive location, per component or global. For now, we don't want to tackle the interactive location. So I think global will be okay. You want to set it once, straightforward for everyone. You can move on with that. Okay, so let's see. Now we have this set. We can now go ahead and I'll create this. .NET 8, make sure you have this framework installed as well. You know, these scaffolding issues or these scaffolding features were introduced in also web API. So, you know, in ASP.NET Core web API, you can scaffold and create your DB context, automatically create your CRUD, your controller for all the CRUD operations, create, read, update, and delete. The same feature has been introduced in the Blazor, and that is what you're going to have a look. The first thing that you need to do here is to create your model. Okay? That's the only thing that you need to do, create your model. So let's create a simple model for this. And with this, we're going to use maybe customer, product, etc. We can use product for an instance, and let's see how it goes. So first, we're going to create a folder in here, and we're going to name this as maybe models or something like that, entities, whatever. So models, we're going to create a model for this, and we're going to use product. So let's see. I'm going to have product model. Now this product model, you know, we need to specify some properties. And the first thing that we need to do here, we need an ID for primary key purpose. We also need a name, isn't it? So let's have name for our product. Then maybe we can have the product quantity. We cannot talk without adding. Let's make it price. Okay. And so maybe we have this. And now what we have, we need to create a DB context class. We need to create a connection string. We need to register these connection strings in the program.cs file, isn't it? That is what you've been doing. That's a normal thing that everybody for a Blazor programmer will do. But in this case, all that you need here is your model. The DB context is going to be created automatically. Your connection string will be created and registered automatically. Isn't that nice? Yes, the only thing that I need to do is to create your model, and that is all. Let's see the way forward. So we have this, let's save this one. Now right click on this, go to add, then have you seen this? New scaffolded item, click on that. Now we want to use for Razor component. In Razor pages, it was available since .NET 7, .NET 6. We can create a Razor component. But this time around, we want a component. That is a Blazor component. So click on the Razor component. Now you can see that this .NET 8, Razor component using entity framework were introduced. So we can have this option attached. And that is what we need. This one. Yes. So you can see it generates Razor component using EF call for create, delete, details, edit, and list. That is a CRUD. Let's click on add and let's add this. Okay, I believe you've seen it before, right? If you've used this scaffolding options in Netcode or API, you know this. If not, this what we need a template. What we need here is we need a CRUD. So you can decide to make a change. You can limit it. You can specify it. I want only create. I want only edit. I want only delete. I want to see only detail. I want to see the list. But this time around, we want to have all the four or the five. Now we need to choose our model class. And where's our model class? That is a product that we created. So can you find it in here? Product, you see this? So choose the model class here. Now the DB context, we have no DB context. So instead of you creating your own, well, you can create your own and unselect it here. But don't worry, let this this new feature do everything for you. Okay, so let's click on create, and now with this we can create our DB context nicely by clicking on this button. So you can give it a name. So let's maintain the name that has been given to us. So this is a DB context. Now the database provider is what you need. Also, you need, do you want to use SQL Server? Do you want to use SQLite? You want to use any of these? Yes, you can decide to choose SQLite, you can decide to use SQL Server, and etc. But with this, I think I'll go with an SQLite, because it's going to be a simple website for you and for me as well. Okay, so let's click on add, and as you see, this is going to install these packages. So it's going to install this code generation.design. After that, it's going to install EF Call Tools. It's going to install the EF Call SQLite. Okay, and it's going to generate the DB context for us. It's going to register our product model and create a table for us. It's going to register create connection strings and also register the connection string in the program.cs file. Let's wait for this guy to finish its work. And now let's testify to that. So this is done. Have you seen the magic that it has performed? Now you see we have all the components in here. And now our edit components created for us automatically. Our input elements such as these input tests, validations, and a whole lot, everything. Check it out. So you see that we have everything here. Now if you want to check, go to the components and pages. Now you see we have a folder called product pages. We did not create any folder that it is the whole system which has created it for us. Now if I open this, you see we have all the CRUD operations here: create, delete, detailed, edit, and index, which give us the list of the product. And it is using the new quick grid. If you don't know how to use quick grid, then I have a video done on that. I'll put the link in the video description. But this automatically installs a quick grid, and it has used it, defined the properties, and now we have everything that we need. You see this, you can now edit it, we can view this one, we can also delete it. This gives us the list. Aside from that, edit, we have it in here. You see, we have this, the route that we have. And inside this, we have this as a parameter which is going to be provided. You see, then we can straight ahead everything is set. Yes. And here too, everything is done for us automatically. So you can see db.pruda.add, receive changes, then navigate to the list. Okay, but when we have this, we are not done. Although we have our connection string set up in here from the appsetting.json, you can see we have this connection string created for us. Aside from that, when you go to the program, we have this connection registered. So when you run this, will it work? It will only when you apply migration. How do you do that? So click on this connected services, and you can see that we have an SQL server, we have an SQLite. Since we're going to use an SQLite, we can create migration in here. So as you can see from this, right click on this three ellipses button in here, then you can see we have add migration. So it's using the SQLite, so add migration, and now we need to select this is a migration name. You can change it if you want. Then we can have our, you see, retrieving available DB context class names. So the context class that has been created in here, and that is a demo CRUD DB context. This can be found in the data folder. It's going to wait and now get this for us. We can choose it from here. Click on finish. Then after that, we need to update the database to perform this. And that is all. Now our project will be ready. We can run it and now test it. So let's wait. Yep. So it is ready. Click on finish. And now we can see add a migration. And this folder will be created. We're going to have the file in here. So this is the folder, migration, and that is the name that we provided. You see, this is the name. Now we need to update this. So in the same place, click on that, then update database. Wait to retrieve the context. Click on finish. It's going to update this. Then we can run this. So click on finish to update this. Yeah, so we have it. And you can see we have the file, the database itself in here, right? So now everything is set and done. We can go ahead and run this application. So this is ready. And what we can do here is we have to navigate to product. Now this product is going to give us a list of products, and currently it's empty. So we need to add product. You can see this. So we can click on add, then we can add new product. So all these forms are created automatically. So which product? I want to add anyone. TTV is okay. Then the price is even here. You can have it. And now click on create. This is going to get created. You can see we have it. We can also view details. We have it in here. Back to the list. Edit this. So TV. Edited. Click on save. Now let's see. We have it. Delete. Are you sure? Yes. So that is it. Now you know how to create a simple website using this new feature in less than 10 minutes. Thank you so much for watching, and I'm going to catch up again. Till then, take care.